Basically, you've got your weed bucket. It's a 4-meter one, this. So it's hydraulic pump and worked by electrical switches. You can have them on the joystick on here, which is a constant pressure on that one for on and off. I have it wired this way so that I can just release and it lets go. But it's just the same as a bucket setup on your quick hitch and everything. Swap, interchange with buckets. Obviously the hydraulic pipe on the, so you can get your hydraulic flow to control, and that's basically all there is to run with it. I flail this side with a tractor flail, and then my remit is just to cut the bottom half of the fire bank from vegetation and clear the bottom out. You're not damaging the tow and the environment, which is a big plus nowadays in the environmental awareness. And you're not taking a lot of water way out, because obviously water out with you and sort of real running material, because obviously it's an open back bucket. You're taking all the cut material out of the drain at the same time, whereas with chemicals you're basically just destroying and leaving the vegetation in the bottom. The way you've got weed screens, they get clogged up and will cause flooding issues. Another mechanical advantage, you're going through with the machine, if you come across any physical obstructions to the dike, if you're going through with the machine and weed cutting, you have more capability on the ground of taking that out as and when you come across it, instead of having to call a machine or something back in. On a drain like this, more or less where it's reasonably good going, straight across, one cut, one basket and out, upwards of 2,000 metres in a day is easily possible. You're not putting matter out on the land as such, you're putting it just on the bank to rot down. There's just a grease drive near the rubber cover with the two circlips around it. There's a drive pin with runs into a bearing. Pump 6-7 heaps of grease into it every day, just keep it well greased, and that's basically all the maintenance there is on there. And your wear plates on your drive arms, more or less the same thing, just keep maintenance, just having a look around in the morning, make sure everything's close and tight and pressure on the arms all right. They're a self-maintained pressure on them. The cams just wear out as any moving part does, and replace as and when necessary.